Please welcome Lord Rowe Beddoe, President of the Royal Welsh College of Music and Drama.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Gubler, let me first thank you and the Chamber for the arrangement of this event, for the nomination of the Hollywood group. I'd like to thank, and there are a few thanks, and it's not an awesome thing, but it's important. I'd like to thank 20th Century Fox, who've been so very supportive of this endeavour. I'd like to also thank the Welsh Government, and Minister Edwina Hart, who is here, and they have given us enormous support. The wonderful thing is, as has been mentioned, there are so many members of the family present. Grandson, granddaughter, niece, a special advisor, great nephews, and indeed, granddaughters again. Sorry. But there we are, there's so many of them, and it is so wonderful that they are here. And Kate, unfortunately, cannot be with us because she is in New York and she is performing as we speak. So, I'd like to just say one or two little things about Richard. You've had that wonderful extemporization from Michael about that mythical baseball hotel. We are celebrating today a man of extraordinary talent, above all, a fiercely proud Welshman. And he's looking down right now. He's amused. He's quite amused by it all, really, I think. Because he had that sort of slightly sardonic look in his eye. But he's very proud. And he's very proud it is St. David's Day. And I'll just tell you one or two little things about me. I first met him when I was age 15. And he was some 26. And I was performing in my prep school in an evening of light entertainment, poetry and music. And I was to read one of Dylan Thomas's more famous poems called Fern Hill. And to my horror, I suddenly looked down. It was an open-air affair. And there was Richard Burton. Now, Richard did more, in a way, for Dylan Thomas's poetry than probably the poet himself. And Fern Hill was actually one that was a celebrated rendition. So, I was mortified. But that's where my relationship started, and it succeeded, endured all of his life, and still all of mine. Sadly, it is. We're wearing red socks. Now, red socks is a very special thing. Richard was buried in red socks, and at his funeral, which was in Switzerland, I played the organ, and in this small non-conformist chapel, you could hear, if you honestly heard, the Welsh voices that just raised the roof off the brothers, and families, and all the members that were there singing in Welsh hymns. Anyway, the red socks was something that Richard wore most days of his life. I'm told, well, I'm not told, I know. Obviously, not when he was in costume, but that is the colour of Wales, and that was what he wore, and quite appropriately, they went with it into the coffin. He was an avid rugby fan. In fact, if he hadn't been an actor, he'd have played for Wales as a wing forward. That was his ambition, above all else. You know, this man of so many parts, I think that what we have to understand, that he gave so much to so many people in the charity side. My friendship with him was the most important, I think, of my life. And it's like yesterday when we were together. I had one task only. Lord forbid if I failed. Wherever Wales was playing in the world, I had to telex him in those days, telex, the score. He could be on vacation in Africa, he could be in the Far East, in Mexico, whatever it was. And if I missed by goodness be that I get a rocket. Well, there we are. Dear Richard, it's a fitting statement at this time for him to be placed here, and I'm very pleased all of you are here on this occasion.